Well, a father and son were involved in a bizarre attack while stuck in a traffic jam on I-94. This guy gave a pretty interesting interview to Channel 7 about the whole ordeal. Here's the report. Take a listen.
Michael Mengus says he still can't believe what happened to him around 3 p.m. while on the highway with his son on I-94 near I-96 interchange.
And traffic came to a halt, and I was cut off by a Jaguar.
Michael says everything took a bizarre turn when the man driving the Jaguar landed on the hood of Michael's Dodge Dart.
So the cat comes across and comes across and bam, 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 starts banging on the windshield or the window with a knife in his hand.
Do you think he was going for
it? I don't know. Maybe my life. I have no idea. Thank God Dodge Bill's a good window.
Where do you think he was going to go if it was everybody was parked on the highway?
Well, there's a problem.
Yeah, I just wanted that noise you heard was him spitting something out of his mouth that interview.
Looked like a nail.
You have to see the video.
Was it a nail?
I think it was his thumbnail.
Where do you think he was going to go if it was everybody was parked on the highway?
Well, there's a problem these days. It's called mental illness, okay? And they shut down the institutions, and this guy needs to go to one, okay? Because I don't know what he had in his mind, okay? But you just don't. Ordinary people don't act like this.
Michael says he is grateful he and his son went unharmed, but adds he is certified in martial arts and says he could have defended himself if he needed to.
But yeah, it would have been a different story. You just would have, pat! And that would have been it.
A pat.
He reminds me of Chuck Norris's brother.
Yeah.
That was lost.
Fred Norris.
Norris. The unknown Norris brother.
Uh-huh. There's got to be people that know him.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. Oh, sure. Michael Mengus. There's got to be people that know Michael Mengus. He seems like a character.
I want to know people also who've trained with him in martial arts.
I want to know where you get a shirt with that many colors on it.
I don't know where you could do that.
One side's green, one side's blue. It's got a pink pocket, a pink back. One arm's green, the other one's blue.
He seems like a guy that would have a story for everything.
Oh, yeah, he does. Yeah.
No, I bet he's been through some stuff. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
He's been through some stuff.
Yes.
I don't know what's made him that eccentric. Something has.
Sometimes you're just born that way.
He's like Kenny Powers in a way.
A little bit.
That's what he is. He's like an older version of Kenny Powers.
Yeah. He's our very own Detroit Kenny Powers.
Detroit's
I love
Kenny
the guy.
Powers.
I love the guy.
I do too. He's awesome.
He's entertaining.
That kick was impressive.
Oh my God. I mean,
he would have kicked the out of the guy.
Rob knows him personally, Detroit's Kenny Powers. Is that right?
Yeah, I know him, man.
So what's Michael like in real life?
He is just over the top. You know what I mean? On everything he does, it's just unbelievable how over the top this guy is. But he's a good guy, though, man.
I can tell he's
a good guy.
And he can kick extremely high.
He did.
So he can throw a moonshot, for real.
No, it looked like it. I was like, that foot was up there. Like, he would have kicked someone right in the face.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Back in the day, he showed me a news article that he got in a fight with multiple people, 10 guys. And the news article said Mike Mengus was seen kicking and punching numerous people. And apparently he won.
He is Chuck Norris's unknown brother.
I'm telling you.
Or Michael his son. Mengus has been in a Matrix fight scene.
Find that news article.
Oh my God, there's an article about
he
this
He saved
guy.
It, of course. He shows everyone.
High kick for you. High kick for you. High kick for you.
That's what I think it is.
This man's a legend.
Yeah.
He doesn't realize it yet.
Yeah.
Here's another one who knows him. Jay knows Michael Mengus, Detroit legend. Jay.
I heard you talking about him, and I thought, this can't be that same guy until I heard about the fight in Plymouth. I was in that fight in Plymouth, too.
Everybody was.
You were in that 10-man fight?
Well, so what happened was he told the one guy, hey, wait, you broke my glasses. Where are my glasses at? Or something like that. The guy was believing him, and then Michael grabbed him by his neck and started just kneeing him in his stomach. And then all the friends were like, I can't believe this guy just did this. We were going to let him go,
He used the old, you broke my glasses line.
And then he broke my glasses.
My glasses.
Michael Mengus.
Man, that Plymouth bar fighter, whatever it was.
How epic is that fight, though?
Yeah.
That so many people are like, I remember that fight. we got all the dudes from Plymouth calling in oh, yeah.
We got him! We got him on the phone!
Oh, good.
He's
Thank
on the
God.
Phone.
Thank God.
Michael.
I said, praise the Lord, brother.
Michael Mangus?
You know, Jesus is my best friend because he saved me in that incident. Oh, my God. That was a trip, man.
The Plymouth fight?
Which one? The fight?
If I could have got out of the car, the guy would have been, you know, hey, we'd have been talking a whole new story. Right? But, hey, I couldn't get out of my race. Right, what are you going to do?
It's the man, the myth, the Megas with us here on the Riff Live.
Yes.
Michael, we started talking about your story on 94, but it's led us to discovering all sorts of things about your life from your friends, including the time you fought off 10 guys.
Yeah, Paige and all little Taekwondo, you know what I mean? Not too bad to know that stuff, really.
So 10 dudes, like, jumped you and your buddies, and you had...
Oh, this was Easter Sunday. I came home that night sucking on him. I couldn't chew. Nine guys come out of nowhere after I knocked 3 out in 4 seconds. And then, you know, it was a trip. Yeah, right on Main Street, downtown Plymouth, you know?
Well, people are still talking about it. I mean, people are talking, like, they remember it like it was yesterday.
Okay, so back to what happened on I-94 this weekend. So you're just sitting in traffic in your Dodge Dart, and a guy in a Jaguar gets out and attacks your car?
And we were traveling at a good 80 miles an hour. Oh, hey, 115. Hey, I won't lie. You know, and then the camera's on a freeway. I thought you could rewind these things, so I got a hold of the Channel 7 to find out that you can't rewind them, and I thought I had the guy... So bottom line is, I'm on my way to a job site. Traffic comes to a dead halt. Guy in a Jaguar cuts me off, and I almost slammed into the lady in front of me. Now I can't get out, right? So he's flipping me off. I'm flipping him off. It's going back and forth. Now this guy jumps out of a car and slides the hood of my right, pulls out a knife, and starts trying to break my window. Now I'm scared. I really was. I'm not going to lie to you. I wanted to beat the living crap out of this guy, but I couldn't get out of my way.
Ka-chow. Yeah, he did. And we saw the kick. I mean, we saw that
you can kick, Michael.
The guy on the news said, I had never seen a 53-year-old so limber. I said, man, when I was 18, I kicked a basketball rim 10 feet in the air. So that's up there.
Yes, it's up there.
I'm not joking. It's the truth. I mean, you know.
Right.
Michael.
A couple things I got to ask you. What was in your mouth that you had to spit out during the interview? Like, did you swallow a bug?
Yeah, no. What was weird is I was chewing tobacco. You know,
timing was off.
They should have been a little more professional to wait 3 seconds and then pick up. You know what
That's
I mean?
What I thought, too. That's what I thought, too.
That wasn't my fault. I mean, believe that on the news, but Tara Edwards was the bomb, man. That lady... Oh, man, she said, I could talk to you all day, blah, blah, blah. She was so cool, man. How did you dig that shirt?
Where did you get that shirt?
A woman did call in to say she has the same shirt, but it's actually a female nightshirt.
That's a darn shame. You know? I wish I would have bought that one. I don't get it, man. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a trip, man. That's a trip. I'm glad my buddy called me. Said you're all over 101, man. You got to call him right now.
Michael, thanks a lot for calling in, man. We appreciate getting your side of the story.
Not a problem. Thank you, sir. Have a great day. All right.
See you, Michael. You stay safe.
Michael Megas, all the best, man.
Whoa.
Damn right.
You called down the goddamn Thunder, Dave, and you got it.
That guy is a trip.
He's been through some stuff.
He's a character for sure.
Yeah.
Only a guy like that could get away with wearing that shirt.
I'll be honest.
Yeah.
I'm glad he's on our side.
Yeah, no doubt.
You're right.